Well, hello, and welcome to our beer road trip.
So today we're on a journey to go find us some beer because we get thirsty. But in the midst of COVID-19, the state of Texas, the great Republic of Texas, has deemed it appropriate for us to offer its citizens drive-through beer service at many fine craft breweries around town.
And the great thing is that us in Texas, we're actually leading the alcohol sales of the country right now.
We single-handedly are the drunkest.
Oh, we didn't say that.
No?
Come on.
What is? Oh, I gotta make my orders. Look, Amazon.
Look, then he's gonna go cross over too.
But check this beast out. This is the Craft Tea Peach 5.2 ABA. It was bottled just today, so this is as fresh as it gets. This is from Vallenson's Brewing Company in this beautiful pig-ass can. Now, this is a man can. I bet you anything, if Andre the Giant was to hold this can, it will look like an actual regular-sized beer can for the man. Chaps, you actually had this beer beforehand.
It's pretty tasty.
And so, what can you tell us about it? What's
so
the secret to it?
So you can imagine sitting on a porch, an old school wooden, rocker, and then you got to picture it being about dusk, and the crickets start to go off, and at that moment, then instead of having yourself a nice grandma handcrafted peach tea, you crack yourself open a 34-ounce growler of some amazing crafty peach ale. You're the secondary brewer here, huh?
That's actually Little Val, okay. His son. Little Val's the brewer. So, they've been having a lot of more chances to brew a lot more, experiment with some more things since the tap room's been closed and we've had more space, more times.
So what's been one of your surprise big sellers since going into quarantine?
So we just released the Becky Ruta Monster, which is the first Belgian beer that Val's done. It's a 11.2%, so it's a big golden strong Belgium. Yeah, it tastes like a 6%er though, so you gotta be really careful, but people have been tearing that up.
Now, one thing I noticed that you guys been selling crowlers in
yes,
online
order. So he's had his crowler machine for like 2 years. He never wanted to use it just because he knew the demand for the tap room and cans would be so big, but when this all happened, it got rushed, and so he brought the canning machine, and so now we've been doing crowlers only just because of growlers coming in from so many places. We don't want like cross-contamination in here, mm-hmm. So we moved to just cans only.
Yeah.
And it's been cool, and now since we've done it, he'll probably never be able to not do cans again because people have just been loving it.
He's been very
so
popular
much.
With it.
Yeah.
So I got a strange question. We've been hearing about this ding-dong ditch thing y'all been doing, huh? You want to tell us how that started?
It was just an idea that we had, but we were just finding a way to connect with all our regulars who we love to see every weekend and we weren't able to see. So then we just put something out on Facebook and we just had no idea how crazy it was going to take off. And we were just getting tens, but over 100 messages.
So are they ordering or they're just dropping off like it's a random prize or what is it?
It was a random prize thing. We wrapped it up. It's just a random thing. People would message us telling us, what they love about our brewery. And we would choose, they'd leave us our address and we would just go about choosing it. A few nights a week, we'd head out on the road.
Ninja style, huh?
Yeah, man. We'd go out with like 12 beers, hit like 12 different houses. Yeah. Have neighbors looking at us all crazy and whatnot.
What are y'all doing?